How much wind does it take to blow away your metal roof? Today we do some testing to see just how durable metal roofing material can be. Metal roofing is a great choice, even for buildings in extreme weather environments. Panels and assemblies are tested to make sure they can stand up to the harshest conditions. I'm here in West Palm Beach, Florida. I'm going to meet Dave and Jeff. We're at Intertek Laboratories today, and we're going to do just that. We're going to take some aluminum panels, put them through the ringer, and see how they hold up. What's up, Dave? How's it going?
Hey, how are you?
Jeff? Dad, how are you?
So we're here at Intertek in West Palm Beach, and what kind of testing are we going to be doing today?
Fast and furious.
We're doing UL580 testing for uplifts. We're doing ASTM 1646 testing for water penetration.
Okay, well, let's go blow some stuff up.
Sounds
right
good.
Right on.
We're beginning with the UL580 test. This measures panel performance in a high wind environment.
580 test is a 10 by 10 deck specimen that is basically built just like the assembly would be on your roof.
The only thing different is that you have to put a plastic sheathing on it because the plastic sheathing helps keep the pressure inside the test chamber so it can actually maintain pressure to give it the uplifts.
These standing seam panels are installed with clips hidden under each seam. Spacing of the clips for an engineered assembly will vary by profile and the substrate the panel was formed from. The entire assembly must be installed to meet the preset engineering requirements. The test will provide proof that if those engineering specs are strictly followed, a roof should perform up to the conditions we subject the test specimens to.
If you don't test them, you don't know how they're going to perform. I can tell you, with our clip spacing on certain deck assemblies, exactly how it's going to perform or how it should perform if it's installed per those conditions. If I guess and I tell you, okay, well, if you put your clips at 4 foot on center, you're going to be fine, I have nothing to back that up with. So we test so we know how the products are actually going to perform in the field.
After the panels are installed, the entire deck is fastened down on the perimeter. The completed deck is marked and loaded into the testing chamber. The chamber creates an airtight seal and uses a blower system to apply different pressures. There are gauges inside to measure the flex of the panels. So we're at the testing area. Tell me what's in the machine right now.
Right now we got the 1¾-inch snap block over plywood being tested.
The test chamber has positive and negative pressure, so it's pushing from the bottom and it's sucking from the top. For UL580, you go through three classes, UL 30, 60, and 90. Each phase lasts 120 minutes.
Each of the three phases applies a specified amount of static and oscillating pressure for the test duration. UL30 applies 45 PSF of pressure, UL60 applies 75 PSF of pressure, and UL90, 105 PSF of pressure.
After you pass UL30, you move on to UL60, UL60, you move on to UL90, and then after UL90 is completed, you move on to 1897, which is ultimate failure. And they basically bump the pressure up in increments on the negative pressure until the panel system actually blows apart, seam fails, clip fails, whatever the failure mode might be. But then you basically see how strong of a pressure it can take before it breaks apart.
So when you hear that an assembly is rated class 60, that means in testing, it is successfully held up against the pressure imposed during class 30 and class 60. And in the same way, an assembly rated class 90 has withstood class 30, 60, and 90 pressures. The deck we had loaded into the test chamber completed each of the test phases through UL90. We then moved on to 1897 to see how much further the assembly would go before ultimate failure. Our deck finally popped the seam after continuing through 1897, and the test was complete. Jeff and Dave made sure to investigate what part of the assembly failed before moving on to another test and test specimen. On this trip, we're testing multiple panel profiles and assemblies. This assures that the material will hold up to the elements in several different configurations and setups. Based on these tests, having an engineered metal roof assembly installed is the best way to know your roof will stand up to extreme weather.
Well, metal roofing is as good as you install it. I've seen systems where the roof stayed on and the deck pulled off. So the metal roof stayed attached, but the deck didn't make it. I mean, obviously there are conditions that nothing is gonna last, but if you install it per the environment that you're in, you know, you have the best chance that you can.
The second test we will be performing is the ASTM 1646 water penetration test. This tests to see if the material or assembly leaks when positive pressure is applied. It starts by building an open frame deck. Again, here we are building multiple decks and types of systems. Water is sprayed onto the panels while positive static pressure is being applied. The test runs for 15 minutes, then the deck is inspected for leaks. Our specimen passed the ASTM 1646 test with flying colors. It really was eye-opening for me to get a chance to see a few of the tests performed on engineered metal roofing systems. Be sure to check out our engineered versus non-engineered Q&A episode to learn even more about this topic. Before I had to catch a plane back home to Cleveland, I talked to Jeff one more time about how important testing really is.
If testing wasn't important, nobody would do it. You know, that's the whole reason we come down here to the labs and we do the tests and we go through the process to make sure that the products we provide, you know, can perform to the needs of the customer. Make sure that you're using an engineered metal roof system if you get one put on your building.
Today we saw some examples of standards testing, and we learned that it's important to test so that you can be assured the roof above your head is going to be safe, durable, and last a lifetime. Thanks for tuning into the episode today. Check us out at Sheffield Metals Online, subscribe to the Metal Roofing Channel, comment with any questions, and as always, I'm Thad Barnett. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
I want to thank a lot of people. I want to thank Phillips Metal Products. I want to thank Temple Architecture. I want to thank Quality Seamers, Triangle Fastener, NovaFlex, Schulmeister Metal Products. You know, those are all the products that we use in our assemblies, and a lot of it was donated. I want to thank Intertek for getting us in so quick. A whole lot of people were involved in this week that was coming down here to the lab to get this done. It wasn't just us putting it on.